1.5 degrees Celsius. It's the most important number in the world right now. If we don't stop the Earth from getting that much hotter, we're kind of screwed. And we're already at 1.1 degrees. But who's meant to be stopping it? Why is there so much jargon everywhere? And how can you make a difference? In this series, we're clearing up the confusion, getting behind the jargon, and explaining exactly how we can get it done. Welcome to 1.5 degrees of confusion. Carbon neutral and net zero are trending right now. Visit a supermarket and you'll see carbon neutral in every aisle. And net zero seems to be the current buzzword for every media company and tech giant. But aren't they the same thing? Well, no. This episode, we're explaining the jargon and asking, what's the difference between carbon neutral and net zero? Let's start with the basics. Both terms are about carbon, more specifically, carbon dioxide or CO2. You know, the stuff that's released when we burn fossil fuels, which as a society, we do quite a lot of. So if we're producing all this CO2, how can anything be carbon neutral? Well, in 1992, the UN realized that global warming was already becoming a problem and asked scientists for ideas. Their solution? A system of carbon avoidance known as carbon offsetting. Here's how it works. Let's say you're a business with pretty high CO2 emissions. You want to reduce them, but making changes to your business is expensive and difficult. Yawn. Then you hear about carbon offsets. These are certified methods that stop CO2 entering the atmosphere by making sure it stays locked in forests or by building renewable energy projects like solar, wind or hydro. Basically, if your business produces 1 ton of CO2, you can buy these offsets, which stop 1 ton of CO2 entering the atmosphere somewhere else in the world. So you buy a few of these and congratulations, your business is now carbon neutral. But like an acrobatic accountant, you haven't actually changed how much CO2 you're emitting. You've just balanced the books. This is where net zero comes in. Net zero is carbon neutral's future thinking, more responsible, better looking older brother. It considers all the emissions of a business and its supply chain, then finds ways to reduce them by at least 90%. These are methods like switching energy sources, using green transport, reducing air travel, and looking at the end life of products. Of course, some emissions can't be avoided, but up to 10% of these can be compensated with carbon removal techniques, nature-based solutions like wetland and peatland restoration, or some of the new smaller-scale technologies that capture carbon from the atmosphere and store it. So as solutions go, carbon neutral is a little bit underwhelming and will never work in the long term. Businesses get to shove their CO2 under the global carpet and let it be someone else's problem. Net zero gets that carpet and gives it a deep, deep clean. It's longer term, more rigorous, and by far the best hope for a 1.5 degree future. Sure, it relies on us all making big changes to reduce our emissions, but the technology and techniques we need are right there. We just need the will to take action. To learn more about how you or the business you work for can reduce your greenhouse gas emissions, visit ecology.com/zero. In this series of 1.5 degrees of confusion, we compare individual climate impact to business climate impact and explore the tricky task of speaking to our bosses about workplace emissions.